Hello guys, this is Shandesu. How are you all doing? I hope all is well with you. Just wanted to make a short video on how we will change the engine coolant of Duke 390 second version. So to begin with, we need to flush the coolant from the reservoir first, which you find here. You can see. So we need to remove this pin over here, move it up, then plug this out and use a drain pan to flush out that coolant from there. After that procedure, we need to flush out the coolant from the radiator through remove coolant from the radiator from the radiator by unscrewing that drain plug over there. Hope you can see in the video. That's the be careful, make sure there's a washer on top of that. Make sure you don't lose any part. Keep it separate so that while you're done, you will have all the parts to finish it. So we'll do all this step by step. First we need to unscrew these two bolts and two bolts over here, and don't remove the whole cap, the cover. Just unscrew those four bolts which I showed you, so that you can tilt this a little downward and have complete access to this cap. So let's begin. So first I will need to unscrew this. Let's remove this first and then drain the coolant from the reservoir. So to remove those bolts, I'm using this particular screwdriver, and this sort of screw which is like helps like an Allen key to unscrew those bolts. Okay, so let's get on with it. Just give me a bit and unscrew it. Finally, I remove the radiator cover. Only one side, and remove the hole. So two bolts here and one over there and one over here. This was a slight problem here when I was removing this. Even this thing was turning, so I used a 12 millimeter spanner, held it tight over here, and unscrewed the bolt, small nut. Please make sure you don't lose any washer. Very important. Okay, now let's go ahead. Don't remove this cap yet. First thing what we have to do is use a nose player and loosen that and push it up. Hold like that and move it upward. Okay, just give me a bit. Okay, I moved this all the way up. Okay, here there's nothing inside the tube. You see this small pipe over here, it comes till here. So this pin you need to pull all the way up so that you'll have free access to remove this. This will take a bit of a time because It's a little tight. Okay, that is done over there. Give me some time. Okay, the pipe is almost up, and I got something like this done for the coolant to drain the old coolant. So here we go. I kept it over here. It's already green in color, man. Let's wait until it's completely emptied. Okay, the reservoir is emptied, but I thought I'll remove some more residue from the reservoir. I just shook the bike a little and some black sort of thing was coming through, maybe dirt or grit, I don't know. I'm surprised, man, it is green. I mean, as per what I know and learned from my riders, when it turns green, it is completely gone. You can't use it. This is my mistake, because I only got the reservoir filled with the new coolant and did not check what is in the radiator. So yeah, that is a mistake. I will not do it again. So whenever you want to change the coolant, make sure you change what is inside the radiator also, and also fill the reservoir with the new one. If you only fill the reservoir with new coolant, what happens is the old coolant that's already in the radiator, it's already turned green, and you know that won't help with the new coolant, and you won't even know, right, why to let your bike get spoiled. So make sure to have a check on the coolant which will be inside the radiator. So as per what I know, I think around 250 ml coolant will be in the reservoir here, and remaining 750 will be inside the radiator and the full system. So yeah, and for your information, the coolant lasts for a year until it turns green like this, which is not a good sign. Okay, so let's get started. So I'm thinking of putting some distilled water there to flush out the remaining dirt. So give me a bit. Okay, I put some distilled water there inside to clean the. I could see some dirt underneath, so I wanted to flush that out. It's falling drop by drop, almost done. So I'm leaving it at that. So let's remove the belly pan now, for we need to remove the coolant from the radiator. So to remove that, I hope you can see, we need to remove these two bolts here, and there's one bolt over here, and we need to remove two Allen key screws from. Finally, I got the belly pan removed. Thought of washing it a bit. There's a lot of grease, grit, and dirt all over it. So to remove the two screws here, I used 10 mm and this particular tool, very useful actually. And I have to remove these two using an Allen key. Use this Allen key and the whole thing came off. Now we need to unscrew this. Please make sure you don't lose the washer on top of it, okay? It's very important. What is this crap? Okay, let's go ahead. Okay, to remove that bolt, you need 8 mm, okay, millimeters. Let's unscrew it. Once it's almost ready to be come off the bolt, make sure you have the drain pan or the funnel or whatever you use to drain the coolant ready, so that you know you won't spill it on the floor and make a mess. Okay, I'm all set now. So just need to remove this bolt. Yeah, almost done. Yeah, there you go. Make sure you don't close this. So keep it right below the engine. You see, nothing is coming out right. So for that, you need to unscrew, open the radiator cap. Slightly just loosen it. Okay, let's loosen this cap. It's really tight. So once you loosen this, air pressure is unlocked. So, and then it starts draining. Just give me a bit. There you go. I loosened it. And oh crap. Made a lot of mess. I think the pipe I used was too long. So DIY, I hope you understand. The shorter the better. I need to clean all this crap from underground. Okay, now this is done. So next what we have to do is fill the radiator with the distilled water, and close this cap, put the drain bolt, and run the engine. Wait for the radiator fan to kick in. That means all the distilled water will go throughout the system, and all the remaining residue of the coolant will be mixed with the distilled water, and then off the engine. Again, we need to unscrew the bolt and remove all the coolant out. Okay, I filled the distilled water. It's up to the brim. After draining the coolant, right, you need to put the nut back. And then close this cap. Make sure this is connected, okay? Where is the key? I'll open this back. Watch closely how to do it. You see this? It should come here. Press it. Turn all the way till it holds. Somewhere here, unlock, isn't it? Discretion, use cloth. Already did this process thrice. This is the fourth time. It was really dirty, man. It was green in color. So when the coolant leaked, right, I had to pause the video there. So now let me give you a brief. So first thing what I did was the engine is cool, okay, first drain all the liquid from the reservoir by loosening this. You have to hold a nose player, hold this together, then it will become expand, then you have to bring it till here, pull the plug out and all the liquid will come out. Now even though that is clean, here still there will be some dirt and some liquid left. So what I did was I opened this coolant cap, put the distilled water and unplug this again and remove all the water from there. After that was clean, I put this back. Then I went forward with removing coolant from the radiator. Now first what you have got to do is remove the belly pan, okay, and then be ready with the drain pan. So what I used was this pipe, so this bottle, you can see it is fogged up because the coolant was hot. Use a drain pan, or if you want, if you have no option, use this along with a pipe. A short pipe would be preferred, like this. Drain it, only little will fall, okay, say I'll show you now in the video, only little will fall. So to why that happens is because of the air pressure. So to release the air pressure, you need to turn this, okay. Let me show you. Now I have filled the distilled water. Now I need to on the engine for 1 minute or two, so that all the distilled water will run throughout the system, mix with the coolant, and then we can drain it out. Okay. Let's begin. Drain plug check. Run the bike for a minute or two. Let's begin the process. First, remove the drain plug. Unplug this. Be careful, the coolant will be really hot. Be ready to away from there, or I recommend wearing gloves. Okay, plug is removed. Now, okay, it's ready. Be drained. Now we have to loosen this. Sorry for the background. Dogs jealous of each other. Started to come out. Okay, don't open it completely. You can see now it's draining and it looks like clean water. I think that's sufficient. This is the fourth time I'm doing, pretty tiring, man. So after this, I'll put the coolant. I've drained all the liquid, and as you can see, I showed you it was white, so I'm pretty sure it was clean. Once the water is completely drained, move the bike to and fro holding the seat, okay, so that when you do that, right, more water which is on the base of the engine casing, it will come out, which the remaining water comes out. and then after that tighten this bolt. So next, now we have to fill the coolant, the engine ice which I was talking about. So for that, make sure you clean all your equipment. I cleaned the equipment with the distilled water, made sure no coolant was in it. So now I have to use the engine ice. Finally getting my chance to open this. Okay, it's done. Open, it's sealed. King man. Even after this, there's a small lamination. Pretty good. Okay. Go ahead and top up. Okay, I filled the coolant. Which is nice. Now, let me on the engine. Throttle a little so the air bubbles come out. You can see the bubbles coming out. Okay, the coolant is up to the brim now. Even after throttling or running the engine, the coolant didn't go down. Once it went down, right, for the first time I refilled. I put some more, just a little, maybe 2-3, you know, drops from the can. Now, let's fill the reservoir also. To fill the reservoir here, if you can see, there's I hope you can see, there are two marks over here. The coolant level should be in between, alright, not high, not too low, should be perfectly half. Okay, let me fill the. So if you can see, it's right in between. So I'm done now filling the reservoir. You can see in the video that blue liquid over there. It's right in between. Okay, I filled the reservoir and started the engine. For a minute or so. Now the final step, what you have to do is the radiators fill to the brim, alright, that is fine. Now, I kept it on, open on the engine, throttled a little, and you saw all the bubbles coming out. Do that until you see no bubbles. Once that's done, there's no air in here. But once you put coolant in from the reservoir, the coolant comes to fill the remaining. There's a slight gap, right? So obviously the gap between the coolant that's remaining in radiator and the coolant that's coming in from the reservoir, yeah? There'll be a slight delay, right? So when it reaches inside, there will be air again. So you need to remove that by loosening a small nut called the bleeder. Okay, just torque it twice until you see coolant leaking down. Just a little one, two. Okay. Finally, it's done. I checked the bleeder, I torqued it twice, loosened it too, and liquid was on the wheel. That means there is no air in the system. Okay, air pockets. I just ran the bike, man. I can't believe it really works. Sorry about that background. After reaching 4 ticks on the temperature, the coolant is good, man. Not much hot air is coming. It's really cooling up. Yeah, see, the fan is on now. It's not as hot air. So, finally, it's done. I put the coolant and it's really working, man. So no issues so far. The procedure was right, else it would have heated up and, you know, the engine would have seized. So if you did like this video, do give it a thumbs up. Sorry for the inconvenience. I ran into a trouble while removing the coolant, so had to cut short the video in between. As you can see, a lot of spills over here and there. So do give it a thumbs up, please do like and share and subscribe, and I'll see you until next time.